Hello, my dear students of class 9. Now, mild the mist up on the hill, last day I told you the first two stanza. And I hope you have done the summary, you have write down the summary and the perfect word notes from here. So, let's start and write down the words what I am giving now. There is mild, reminds, upon, feel, wept, spent, silent, sheltering roof, knit. That's all. I think you have write down this one and check it. You just write down the meaning and the parts of speech as last day I told you. Now today I am going to discuss about the third and fourth stanza. Third and fourth stanza, which is very important for you. And I also given some questions on last day. I think you have write down this one. So after the lessons, I will discuss all this and I will also give some questions to you. আমি আগেই বলেছি তোমাদের কিন্তু কবিতা ভালো করে বুঝতে গেলে যেটা চাই সেটা হচ্ছে মুখস্থ। আমি জানি তোমরা মুখস্থ করেছো অ্যান্ড ইউ হ্যাভ রাইট ডাউন ইন ইউর কপি, আদারওয়াইজ কিন্তু এটা চিরস্থায়ী হবে না, মনে থাকবে না। সো বিফোর গোয়িং টু ইউ জাস্ট ট্রাই টু থিঙ্ক অ্যাবাউট দিস ওয়ার্ডস। দিস ওয়ার্ডস আর ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট। ওয়াচ, দ্যাট মিন্স অবজারভেশন, ক্লাউডি, দ্যাট ফুল অফ ক্লাউড, ফল, দ্যাট ইজ কভার, সেভারাল মিস্টস, sweet mist, sorry, that is pleasant season, it indicates the pleasant season, horizon, the lines of distance where the sky marked with the arc, mountain chain, that is hill range, damp, that is moist, stands, that is remains thick, dense, morning tears, that is phrase, it's now dews of the morning, dreamy, with dream, and scents, that is odor or ascent, fragrance, that is sweet smell, and past, that is blow. Now come to the lesson. You know, I watch is cloudy, this cloudy evening fall after a day of rain, blue mist, sweet mist of summer fall, the horizon's mountain chains. Now poet actually inside the old door, which was reminds her about her past life. Everyone's have the past life. So please think about that. What does the narrator actually wants to say here? The third stanza, poet expresses her view, the cloudy evening. The evening which is full of cloud, it's covered with the full of clouds after a day of rain. So, you know, when the cloud covers everywhere, little bit rain before that. So the poet describes here that the sky is full of cloudy, full of cloud, and just the evening fall, just the evening is emerging, just the evening is starting. Blue mist, sweet mist, a summer fall. In the meantime, just think about the what pictures is, how the image is now going to be set up. One way, the cloudy weather. After the rain, there is a soaked, you know, the mud is soaking. There is a soaked ascent is coming here. Besides it, the blue mists, you know, it's the blue mists. Mist means me to jano tumra to kuasha. Blue mist, sweet mist. The mist is now actually attractive. It's a shining and summer fall. So, there is little bit hot. The horizon's mountain chain. Look at the far away horizon where the sky and the earth actually meets the end of the earth. You know, horizons means, you know very well, where the line, that is, it is a line, if you stand on the upper portions of your earth and look far away, you have seen the sky and the earth actually meeting line. That meeting line actually called horizon. That horizon's mountain chain, and it's very clear where there is a hill. When hill and the sky covered with the cloud, and after all, there is a blue mist and sweet mist, you know, it's a great look, it's a great pictures. So the third stanza actually provide you the scenario beauty on that particular time when the Emily Jane Bronte actually waiting in the hall. And it's give you the different imagery, different image picture, which will turn you towards the different world. Now come to the second stanza, the last stanza or the fourth stanza. What is this? ভালো করে পড়বে কিন্তু না পড়লে কিন্তু পারবে না. The dam stands in the long green grass as thick as morning tears, as thick as morning tears, and dreamy scents of fragrance pass that breathe of other years. You know, the little bit rain was there. So I told you, there is a soft, muddy, and there is sweet smell in the air. And in the long green grass, you know, where there is a damp weather, where there is a little bit wet weather, you will get a very green grass everywhere. And you know, the green always refresh your mind. As thick as morning tears. Now, the poet actually compares it with the tears of the morning. Means, the morning is a character which provides you a different look. A little bit tears is coming out from the eyes and it creates another look of the earth. And dreamy scents of fragrance, dreamy scents, the scents normally you will get. But it's a dreamy sense, the sense which is very much attractive or very much close to your mind. Fragrance pass. Dreamy sense of fragrance pass. Fragrance, you know, sweet smell, you know, they're actually passing away. And it reminds the poet that breathes of other years. It's actually reminds you what happened in your past life. So this is the external sense of the poetry. Aste aste ba 10 8 11 utbe to now ekta practice kore now internal sense and external sense. Already I have discussed the external sense. Now come to the internal sense. What is the internal meaning? Kintu bar bar ami bolchi er shonge tomader ki jeta mone rakhte hobe, you have to remember these words. Now what is the third stanza actually? Internal, the last year I told you the first and second stanza are internal. Now today I am discussing about the third and fourth stanza. These two stanzas actually provide you, actually expresses that somehow, wherever I am in a grief, I am in a unhappy mood, but where there is a, you know, problem, there is a solve. Life is not always smooth. Maybe there is a cloudy weather there, but somehow, you will get some focus of light through the blue mist, sweet mist inside the summer fall. Whatever the problem, whatever the cloud, whatever the obstacles is coming to your life, it will be overcome. And for that, you have to look far. Not now, not here. You have to look about the future. Look far, that is long horizons. And the last paragraph, last stanzas will provide you. The last stanza is now very attractive for all. What? No. The damp stands in the long green grass. That means, what is sweet? What is happy? What is actually favorable in life that will stick forever? And what is truth? It's never be diluted. So the sweet, lovely scents means the life, sweet part of the life, good part of the life, happy mood of the life, always reminds you about your happy past. I hope you have realized this one. So write down the summary and the internal sense of this poetry. If you write down the internal sense, I think you have no problems at all. Er shonge dutu questions ektu bhalo kore lekho. Ekhane je gulo ache, ei je exercise 2 ebong exercise 3. Exercise 2 to jeta ache seta ektu korbe ar exercise 1 ta korbe er shonge ami koyekta question dicche sei questions gulo tumi kore nebe seta hocche how was the cloud what is the scenery on that particular morning. What happened in the evening? What happened if there is a stamp or green grass or, you know, damp weather? And finally, you just try to remember that, write something, some words about your childhood. Write 10 lines about your childhood life with your parents, with your family. That's all. I think you have remembered this one. Next day, I will discuss about the exercise and the other portions of your lessons. Thank you very much.